WikiLeaks, and the Imperial Press. The release of some 70,000-plus files from the Afghanistan war has been treated by most corporate media as, at best, a minor irritant, and worst, an act of treason. The instincts expressed by these outlets betrays the same mindset that whipped the nation to war in the aftermath of 9/11. Media as servant of presidential power, and media as servant of the empire and the defense industries. Julian Assange of WikiLeaks has been lashed for not caring sufficiently for U.S. soldiers or secret informants in Afghanistan. His other offense? Counting the deaths of Afghan civilians killed by U.S. troops. For most of the media, that's a no-no. That's what the imperial media sounds like. As it stands, American corporate media is fast becoming a vanishing breed. For less and less people watch TV news or read newspapers. Furthermore, young people are leading this trend. According to some reports, the average U.S. newspaper loses 10% of its readership every year. While technology undoubtedly plays some role in this process, the lack of trust must also be a factor. Their flag waving and martial music led the nation into disasters in Iraq and Afghanistan. When an outfit like WikiLeaks comes along with raw data from the battlefield and secret files, the corporate media seems superfluous. And now, like underfed pit bulls, they attack WikiLeaks for not playing their imperial game. They're barking, but WikiLeaks is biting. From Death Row, this is Mumia Abu-Jamal. These commentaries are recorded by Noel Hanrahan of Prison Radio.